Thomas and the Blue Hedgehog.
It was a beautiful morning on the island of Sodor.
All of the engines on the Fat Controller's railway were working as usual, pulling coaches, shunting trucks, and delivering the mail. One day, there was a poster about a blue hedgehog. And at the bookstore, stories were written about the blue hedgehog. The children loved reading the books about this creature. But the engines weren't so sure. At Tidmouth Station, Thomas was waiting to pick up his passengers from Bertie the bus. Soon enough, Bertie arrived in the nick of time.
Here are your passengers, Thomas.
Thank you, Bertie.
As Thomas waited for the passengers to board on Annie and Clarabelle, he sees Edward and Percy talking to each other next to a signal box where Donald had his accident. But he couldn't hear what they were talking about.
What do you think they were talking about, Bertie?
Probably just learning about words that Percy could pronounce correctly.
Maybe for you, Bertie, but I'm not so sure.
Just then, Donald and Douglas came up next to Thomas.
Ah, Thomas! Just the wee engine we was looking for.
Aye, that's right, Donny.
Oh, hello, Donald and Douglas. You wanted to see me.
Of course, lad. Have you heard about the children?
No, what about them?
Forgetting a ditty from this creature that we're reading from the bookstore.
Creature? What creature?
The Fast Blue Hedgehog is what it's called, and it has the same color as your paintwork.
But that's impossible. It can't have the same color as me.
Thomas is right. Guardian and Edward also have their blue coats of paint.
Yeah, well, sort of a hedgehog.
Of course, you may be thinking that this hedgehog is a figure of our imagination, but no, this hedgehog is something else.
No, me a hedgehog can never roll around or even run fast. Especially since it was made famously from Japan.
This made Thomas very confused.
How come no one has ever told me that there would be another blue character?
Suddenly, the guard blew his whistle, causing Thomas to jump.
Oh, sorry, fellas. Got a branch line to run.
Was that too much?
Nah, he'll get over it, brother.
The Fat Controller was eating his ice bun when he heard knocking on his door.
Yes, who is it?
It was the station master. In his arm, he has a newspaper.
You might want to look at this article that I've just read about, sir.
He opened up the page to show the Fat Controller what he was reading.
What's this? Chigan of Japan's mascot Sonic the Hedgehog becomes famous around the world ever since his game release on the Sega Genesis. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Looks like we have another character that's blue.
James and Thomas were waiting at the level crossing. Then Thomas was the first to talk.
I've heard rumors about a fast blue hedgehog, and that it's very famous in Japan.
Don't be silly, Thomas. How can there be a fast blue hedgehog?
But then, something appeared in the air. It was a big golden ring. Thomas could not believe what he had seen.
Cinders and ashes!
What's wrong, Thomas? What's with the face?
But before Thomas can explain, a creature was shot out from the ring and landed its feet on the rails. No one said a word until the ring faded away. James's driver broke the silence.
What is that thing?
The blue creature looked all over his surroundings. Thomas's driver spoke next.
Looks like a big hedgehog. A blue hedgehog?
It was indeed a blue hedgehog, but it was no ordinary hedgehog. Its blue quills were like spikes, and its ears were shaped like triangles. It was wearing red sport-like shoes, white gloves, and its color skin is the same as any human. Thomas then remembered what Donald and Douglas had said.
It's the fast blue hedgehog.
James, on the other hand, was not convinced.
Are you sure, Thomas? I don't like the way it looks.
Of course I'm sure, James. How can I not be sure?
It's just that I've never seen a blue hedgehog before. In fact, it doesn't even look like a hedgehog.
See that? That thing's got an attitude, a bad one.
I think you've made it, Matt James. James, you might want to chuff away.
Are you out of your mind, Thomas? I'm not chuffing away from some silly little creature.
And then it happened.
The hedgehog started running around in front of James. Then it hopped on top of James's boiler.
Hey, you! This is dangerous!
And then it squeezed James's nose like a ball.
Get off! Get off, you silly thing!
Thomas couldn't help but started laughing.
It's not funny, Thomas. This is serious.
You gotta do something!
Finally, Thomas blew his whistle and made the blue hedgehog stop.
Now be a good hedgehog and hop off of James.
The hedgehog did as it was told and hopped off of James. It stood proudly on the tracks, rubbing its finger under its nose.
As soon as I drop off my passengers, I'm heading straight back to my shed. Rather letting this freak of nature go crazy on me.
And off went James in a huff, leaving Thomas and the blue hedgehog on their own, to which it blew a raspberry at the red engine.
We better get it out of here.
Thomas's driver got off of Thomas's cab and started to walk towards the hedgehog. Behind Thomas, Annie and Clarabel were rather worried.
Be very careful.
Don't let the hedgehog hurt you.
I think I can handle this little fella.
The driver stopped in front of the hedgehog and squatted down to match its height.
Hey, buddy, want to ride with us down to the station?
The hedgehog's face lit up when it heard this. It rapidly nodded its head and zoomed into Thomas's cab.
That was quick.
The driver quickly got back onto Thomas's cab. And off they went.
Welcome to Sodor, little hedgehog. I'm Thomas the Tank Engine.
The blue hedgehog was very happy to be riding on a steam engine. And the hedgehog's adventure has just begun. The blue hedgehog joins the steam team. Thomas the Tank Engine is showing the little blue hedgehog all the sights of Sodor. They went past the windmill. And the water mill. At last, they arrived at Knapford Station.
Here we are, little buddy.
Thomas could see that up ahead. The Fat Controller is on the platform.
You see that man with the top hat, little guy? That's a Topham hat, our railway controller.
Thomas, here you are at last.
Hello, sir. Do you want to talk to me about something?
Yes. I have the newspaper.
What does the newspaper have to do with this conversation, sir?
The Fat Controller showed Thomas what's on the newspaper. The Blue Tank Engine had a good look at the words and pictures on the paper. That's when his face went through a lot of emotions. From confused to realization and then surprise.
Since 1991?
Exactly, Thomas.
As the passengers got off of Annie and Clarabel, the driver got off of Thomas's cab and walked up to the controller.
Funny you'd mention that to us, sir, because we've picked up a special passenger just like that.
Really? Who's that?
Suddenly, out jumped the blue hedgehog from Thomas's cab.
My goodness, this must be the Sonic the Hedgehog.
Sonic? Is that what they call you? Well, bust my buffers. That's a perfect name for you.
We found him at the level crossing, and from what we saw, he came through a huge ring. Though he's not much of a chatterbox, aren't you, little fella?
What can we do with him, sir, now that he's in our world?
Good question, Thomas.
The Fat Controller had a good long think. Then an idea has struck.
I've got it! We'll have Sonic as our special guest. Thomas, put Annie and Clara back into their sidings and meet me back at Tidmouth Sheds. I'm going to tell the other engines about this.
Yes, sir!
So that's what the driver and Thomas did. But Annie wasn't so sure.
Thomas, are you sure that you and the others can cope with that hedgehog?
Trust me, ladies. Sir Topham Hatt knows what he's doing.
That evening at Tidmouth Sheds, James rolled into the shed without saying a word.
What's the matter with you, James?
Nothing, Henry. Nothing at all.
Then what's with the face you're giving us?
Surely something must have happened. Come on, James. Share something of what happened.
Yes, let's all hear what had happened.
Yeah, tell us, James. Pretty please.
Okay. I'll tell you all what happened. But only because Percy said please.
So everyone listened.
It happened when me and Thomas were at the level crossing. We were both just waiting for the gates to be opened, when all of a sudden, this blue creature just appeared out of nowhere. It then started going all around me, like as if it's a racing car, hopped on top of my boiler, and squeezed my nose. Then Thomas told it to stop, and it hopped off of me, and I went away to drop off the passengers. So that's pretty much what had happened.
That just made Duck, Henry, Gordon, and Oliver burst into laughter.
That's a good one, James.
Yeah, real funny that is.
No, I'm telling you, it really did happen.
Percy and Edward looked at each other, knowing that James could be right about something.
Oh, goodness.
Settle down, everyone. Sir Topham Hatt has just arrived.
I want to tell you all that we are having a very special guest.
A special guest, sir?
Yes, Oliver. He's so special, in fact, that he made video games since 1991.
Video games, sir?
Exactly, Doc.
How can someone be that famous for making video games?
What's a video game?
Here comes Thomas.
Who's ready to see our special guest?
We all do, Thomas. Sir Topham had told us about it.
Yeah, Thomas. We want to see this special guest.
Okay, then. That's your cute little buddy.
The engines were completely speechless.
Now, I can tell by your faces, but this is our special guest, Sonic the Hedgehog, one of Duckhead's famous mascot for the company of Sega. Now I want you all to be on your best behaviors, is that clear?
Yes, sir!
Yes, sir.
Splendid! You're all really useful engines.
As the turntable is being turned around for Thomas, James spoke up.
Now, do you believe me?
Oh, we are so sorry, James. See, we thought you were only kidding, but this is actually a real thing.
He looks exactly like the man drew him, doesn't he, Edward?
Yes, he does, Percy.
Just look at what it's wearing. Nothing but gloves and shoes. It's just so off-putting.
I think he's cute.
What are you on about, Henry?
Well, look at him. He doesn't look that dangerous.
Sure, it may look innocent for you. But that hedgehog can literally run around you non-stop.
Also, why isn't he talking?
Sonic's not much of a chatterbox.
He's more of a silent type kind of character.
That explains the hand motions.
And can I just point out that Percy said something about a man that drew Sonic?
Wait, did I say that?
Yes, you did. I saw you and Edward chatting back at Tidmouth Station.
Everyone looked at Percy. Even Sonic, who was tapping his foot. Percy giggled with blushed cheeks.
Percy, you told me about the man who drew Sonic, Thomas.
He said that he was an artist from overseas and was very fond of the hedgehog. So he made a picture of Sonic.
Well, that's great. Another engine who found the blue hedgehog.
Though I think the bigger question is, where did you come from?
Sonic says he comes from an island called Emerald Hill. It had everything. Sandy beaches, palm trees, cascading waterfalls, public access to loop-de-loops. And he can run around the island at the speed of sound along with his friends.
Every engine was amazed at what Sonic the Blue Hedgehog can do.
Also, they had many adventures along the way. For example, they had to stop the Doctor for creating robots named Bad Mix. And he had to rescue another hedgehog named AB from an evil robot version of him. But what more can he say?
Wow, those must have been some pretty amazing adventures. Heck, we even had our own adventures, like the time Gordon got stuck on his hill, and Edward had to...
I think that's enough stories for today, because it's getting late, and I think we should get some sleep, so good night.
Woo! I'm bushed. Good night. Yeah, me too. Good night, fellas.
Nighty night. Good night, everyone.
I'm definitely gonna need some sleep.
Sorry, Sonic, but we do need some sleep.
Sonic's ears drooped down.
But hey, if you want, you can sleep in my cab.
Sonic's face lit up.
How about it, Sonic?
Night came. All of the engines are fast asleep. As for Sonic, he was happily asleep, curled up inside of Thomas's cab, thinking what will his next adventure be. Delivering the mail with Sonic. Spring had come to the island of Sodor. The flowers are blooming. The birds are singing. And all of the engines have started their day of work. Thomas's shed door was opened. And so was Edward's. They both said their good mornings.
Good morning, Edward.
Good morning to you too, Thomas.
Then Thomas peeped his whistle.
Wake up, Sonic. It's morning.
Sure enough, Sonic came walking out of the shed door, looking rather different. He was wearing what looked like a turquoise bathrobe. Thomas and Edward couldn't help but smile at how Sonic does his morning routine. Sonic reached into his robe and pulled out a mug of coffee.
Well, that hedgehog surely knows how to wake up in the morning.
He sure does, Edward. Well, time for me to pick up Annie and Clarabelle. I'll see you around, Sonic.
Sonic waved at Thomas and watched him puffing away to collect his coaches.
You know, Sonic, I'm going to Callan Station. How about you travel around with me?
Sonic's face lit up when he heard this, and nods in agreement.
Then hop on board, little buddy.
Sonic has never ridden on a tender engine before, but knew there was another adventure for him. Edward was coupled up to the coaches. The guard blew his whistle, and Edward started off. Donald and Douglas watched him leave the station.
Make way for the special guest.
Show off.
Meanwhile, Henry was enjoying the sweet sound of nature in his forest.
Don't you just love nature, driver?
Yes, indeed, Henry. Just breathing in that sweet nature smell.
But then, they felt a gust of wind. and were confused about it.
We didn't remember having a gust of wind at this time of day.
Then something bright appeared next to Henry.
What is that?
I can't see!
If these readings are accurate, he's here. I found him. I just hope I'm not too late.
Did you see what I just saw?
I think we did, but I wish we didn't.
So there I was, puffing with all of my might, trying to catch up to James.
You would not believe how much I was panting up there with every ounce of steam I've had.
Then the inspector...
Summit was very interesting, listening to Edward's stories about his adventures. Finally, they arrived at Cowland Station.
And to this day, I've still got my strength, even though I look like an old iron.
Sonic jumped out of Edward's cab and landed on the platform.
Now you just wait here while I put the couches away.
Sonic gave Edward the thumbs up in response, and waited for him to return. As he was waiting, he saw some children coming down the bridge stairs and were running up to him. Sonic had never seen the children this excited to see him.
We've seen you in Daddy's storybooks and on posters.
Please, Mr. Sonic, give us something entertaining.
Sonic couldn't be more happier, so he did. He did every pose that he could think of every time he jumped. He even rolled around the station, pretending to be like a ball. The children watched in amazement. When Edward came back, he was surprised to see Sonic walking on his hands. But even he couldn't help but smile. Sonic finished his performance with a bow. The children clapped and shook Sonic's hands in a way of saying thank you. Then they ran off, pretending to be like Sonic. He watched as the children ran off out of sight.
You're quite the entertainer for a blue hedgehog.
Sonic only shrugged in response. Then they heard a familiar whistle. It was Percy, and he brought the mail train with him.
Why, hello, Percy. Fancy seeing you bringing the mail with you.
You know me, just delivering the mail like Aurelius, the Lingian.
Oh, hello, Sonic.
Sonic pointed at the mail train.
That's right, Sonic. I've got the mail train with me.
That's how the engines bring the mail to everyone's homes.
Me and my friend Thomas do this all the time. I love delivering the mail.
Sonic felt happy at that, but that feeling soon changed. Percy and Edward had never seen Sonic this sad before.
What's wrong, Sonic?
He's saying that there's so much he has never seen or done before, and he and his friends are not with him. And now that he's here with us, his friends have missed their chances.
The two engines looked at each other, feeling very sorry for Sonic. Meanwhile, at Tidmouth Station, Gordon was dropping off his passengers. He sees James next to the point, and can tell from the look on his face.
Still not happy about the hedgehog being a special guest, James?
Of course I'm not happy about that hedgehog being a special guest, Gordon. Hedgehogs are meant to be small and spiky, but this hedgehog is big and blue, and I don't like it, not one little bit.
Okay, listen, I can guarantee you, once that hedgehog has had its fun, it can head back home to its island.
James decided to accept of what Gordon just said.
You're probably right, Gordon.
Then they heard a familiar whistle.
That sounds like Henry.
It was indeed Henry, and he was puffing at a tremendous speed. He even woke Boko up with a shock.
Slow your roll, Henry.
Henry can see Gordon's coaches up ahead.
Gordon! James!
Henry's brakes squealed and screeched as he came to a stop right next to Gordon.
Henry, control yourself.
Yeah, relax, pal. What's gotten into your smoke box?
Yes, now take it easy. Tell us what happened.
Okay. You know how foxes are really capable of what they're doing, and I really love animals. Well,
I was on my break, and I went into my forest to have a bit of time to myself. You know, just breathing that nature smell. Because, you know me, I really love nature. But
this time,
I was
what,
in there,
Henry?
And...
What's going on?
It's the fox. It talks.
Talks?
What do you mean it talks?
Henry explained everything of what the fox looked like. James began to feel nervous.
I don't like where this is going.
But Gordon didn't believe any of it.
That is the most preposterous thing I have ever heard, Henry. Do you actually think that everyone is going to see a two-tailed fox that can fly around like a helicopter and...
He has to be around here somewhere.
Gordon was now completely speechless. And James was already shaken with fear.
It's happening again.
What are we gonna do? We gotta
get help!
No. It's no use.
Gordon, what are you saying?
There's nothing we can do, boys. It looks like we've been invaded.
Back at Cowlin Station, Sonic sat on the platform, feeling very down in the dumps. Poor Percy didn't know what to say to the sad Blue Hedgehog. That is, until kind Edward spoke up.
Don't feel sad, Sonic. Just because you're here with us and your friends are not with you, doesn't mean you have to feel sad.
I'll bet one of your friends is here looking for you.
He says, do you think so?
I know so.
Sonic the Hedgehog beamed from ear to ear. He then jumped around the platform, filled with happiness, which made Percy laugh with joy. Then coming down the road was none other than Tom Tipper and his postman. They told him about Sonic helping out with the mail, to which he agreed.
I could use a bit of extra hands myself.
At Myth Sheds, the Fat Controller spoke severely to Henry.
You know better not to go at high speeds. You could have hurt one of my engines.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir.
And what's with you three in the sheds? Tell me you're not going on strike again, are you?
Of course we are not on strike, sir.
We're only here because we're protecting ourselves.
Protecting? From what?
From the two-tailed fox, that Henry, his driver, and his fireman claims to have seen it in his forest.
We were on a break!
Oh, boy. Elsewhere, the little fox was still on the search for someone. It then landed on Ellsbridge Station.
I've been all over this railway, and still no sign of him. Maybe my tracking device has got a few bugs in it somehow. No matter. I'll just rest here, and then I'll look for him again.
So the little fox rested its head against the lamp pole and fell fast asleep. Then, from around the corner, Thomas appeared with his two coaches.
Strange. No passengers. Henry is always here with my passengers. Who just yawned?
Well, it certainly wasn't me, Thomas.
Yeah, me either. I slept well the other night.
Then who else could have yawned?
I think I found the answer to your question, Thomas. Look at the platform.
Would you look at that?
Look at what, Annie?
That cute little fox, sleeping on the platform like a baby.
I've heard of adorableness, but this is too adorable.
We better take it with us, since it's not going anywhere.
Just because they are creatures from another world doesn't mean you have to be scared of them.
But sir...
Really useful engines don't argue. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir.
Of course, sir.
Excellent. Now off you go. Back to work, you three.
Gordon was the first to leave the sheds and onto the turntable.
I really need to control myself in situations like this.
Thomas, meanwhile, was really thinking over a lot of things.
First, the blue hedgehog named Sonic comes to our world from the rim, and now the little fox was sleeping in Asgard Station. To think the characters come from video games.
And inside his cab, the driver and fireman were figuring out what they have in their hands. They had never seen such a small gadget before.
What do you make of this, Sam?
It looks like some kind of radar of some sort.
When they arrived at Tory Rex Station, Bertie the bus was there.
Hello there, Thomas.
Fancy seeing you here, Bertie. What are you doing here?
Well, I was driving along, having the time of my life, until I picked up a very interesting passenger.
Thomas was just about to ask, when out jumped Sonic from inside of Bertie.
Sonic! Fancy seeing you as well.
I saw him doing some mail delivering with Tom Tipper. He then wanted to take a ride on me, since he's on his break.
Well, Sonic has found a job. I guess that makes him a really useful hedgehog.
Just then, they heard a yawn coming from Thomas's cab.
What was that, Thomas?
Oh, that would be my passenger.
What a good rest that was! Though I don't remember resting inside of a steam engine.
You're talking! Foxes don't talk!
Foxes don't wear gloves or shoes either.
Interesting. These machines also speak in this room. But more importantly, where could Sonic be?
And there, standing next to Bertie, was Sonic the Blue Hedgehog.
There you are, Sonic!
A little fox ran up to Sonic and gave him a hug.
I was looking everywhere for you.
I can see where this is going.
Bertie drove away.
Anyways, my name is Thomas. Do you have a name?
My name is Miles Prower, but everyone calls me Tails because of my two tails.
Later, at Tidmouth Sheds, the engine started getting to know Tails a lot more. Even Percy.
You know all that bad stuff I've said about Sonic. I take it all back.
If he's a friend of Sonic, then he's a friend of ours. Welcome to Sogor Tales.
Thank you, Edward. Thank you very much indeed.
Percy is now friends of both Sonic and Tails. They both have wonderful adventures together. And we all know that adventures can go a long way. Don't we?